ready to call the meeting to order. Looks as if everyone's present. Is there a motion to accept the minutes of the previous meeting?
So moved.
Second.
Is there any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Any extensions? Okay, number three, review and finalize committee's report in reference tables. Alan, would you particularly like to please?
Well, I tried to put into words this, the ideas that we tossed around for a brief report. I kind of divided the report into two sections, really. The first section are those changes that I think we all kind of agreed could be made in the short term without a lot more study, and although there is some more work to do, but without the kind of study that's going to be required for the second category, which is all that separation of powers. And so I thought I would, we would attach the tables, and if in fact the mayor and the council president decided to continue this as a special or select committee, to benefit the work that was done to date. So that's essentially what I drafted. I have no particular pride of authorship, so I'm happy to hear any comments.
No question. I don't know if we may have discussed this last time, but I don't recall. One of the things we were talking about extracting from the code was the ordinance calling for the city to regulate housing authority property.
Right.
Was it, at what point was that legal? I'm
sure there are other things in here that were never legal at any point.
So you think it may have never been legal?
I have a sense when I read the ordinances that there's some ordinances that were passed in response to some specific or particular thing that happened, like a doctor got a ticket while making a house call, and therefore the doctors are exempted, or they were some, you know, I'm presuming Catholic non-citizens hawking fish in the street, and therefore there's a citizenship requirement in order to hawk fish in the street. I mean, I don't.
That's me, sir.
So.
So you mean it may have been passed regardless of legality?
Yeah, I don't think people really thought of some of those things in terms. I don't know how far back that ordinance goes with regard to the housing authority, but. Just not sure that anybody was really paying all that much close attention to it. And they were actually probably responding to something that happened on that property and they passed an ordinance.
I'll go back and look that up, because usually there will be some documentation inside that particular ordinance that will tell you why it was done. I'll just have to go back and pull it out and see what the rationale was for it.
Thank you.
Why do you think that we can regulate?
No, you know? I was just curious as to, you know, I didn't think we ever had, my guess is we never would have been able to, and I said, so I thought it was fine that I was in there again.
No, I think that there's, you know, there are some harbingers of a different time.
There's a piece of property down there that, I don't know, that the city really owned, but it was on housing authority property or something, and that's my recollection. I'll pull it and see what their justification was for that.
Do you think there are some ordinances that we can pass to regulate housing authority property within reason? I would think maybe there are, but I don't know for sure.
Well,
I might couldn't I even make that decision today anyway, but it might be worth it.
Yeah, I wonder if there's reason along those lines, like if we are just absolutely prohibited in one thing or if we can.
And this is about smoking, not smoking, drinking, right?
Yeah.
So, the value of that. They may have their own regulations about it, so maybe not necessary for a second place.
But if, you know, it's at least a quasi-governmental entity and created by statute, so we couldn't prohibit it. State law.
That's why the state law says anything specific about municipalities being able to set reasonable rules.
Sure, the select committee will have a robust conversation about it.
Is there anything else you want to add about your report?
Just that I indicate that this committee has recommended upon its dissolution that a select committee be formed. I tried to avoid suggesting either that this one continue or that they appoint another one or with different members. I just kind of left that.
Other discussions.
Well, thanks for doing this. I think this covers, to my mind, this covers kind of what I thought we would have as a final report.
Does anyone have any questions or changes they would make? Would you be willing to be there when we present this to full council?
What is that?
I don't know yet.
Okay. I'm
probably
willing. I'll let you know if I'm able, but yeah, I'm certainly willing to do that.
I didn't know this was going to full council.
And only supposed to be a report to the city clerk.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, certainly, but I guess that's a copy along with the council, but I mean, other than that, it doesn't seem that the council votes on it.
Are there the three tables from last time? Is that what we're talking about? Those haven't changed.
No, they have, because this one is.
So I've added to that.
Okay.
From the last meeting.
Okay.
I went through, and the only ones I'm missing, and I found out too late today to add them, was I had searched for planning department, not realizing it was in the code book under Office of Planning and Development, so it didn't show up. So there's 19 references that I need to add to that table. But I can do that fairly quickly.
This is table A, I guess.
It would probably be helpful to have that added to the top here so that when I put this to the minutes, it reflected table A. Otherwise, I can just type it on there.
No, I can do that. I'll amend it to add in Office of Planning and Development.
Okay.
The change of that name.
And you have the ones that I did.
Your new ones?
The two other tables that I prepared, one of which would be table B, the one
yes.
You had those tables.
Yes.
I would take out the my little notes in the right hand column. Well, that's my suggestion is to eliminate doctors and put in lawyers.
And do the fourth table, just miscellaneous things?
No, there were three tables. There was the Chapter 174 fees table. There were the incorrect references to boards and committees.
Okay.
There were four tables.
There were four tables. Change
of table. Kind of miscellaneous and...
Miscellaneous and then the separation of powers.
Probably the miscellaneous and the... We can call it separation of powers and miscellaneous and put them all in one table.
Should this be addressed to the clerk because the charter says...
I thought it was a report to the... It's odd that that we would appoint a council and mayoral committee and that the report wouldn't go to them.
That could be in the ordinance.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It says
to
the city clerk.
Yeah. The ordinance.
It's in the charter also, but that's just. Happy to make it to the city clerk. I'll change it to the city clerk and copy to the council president and the mayor. Is there, or somebody else can make that change. Is there a letterhead? You must have letterhead for this committee, because you're...
Well, I can do it if you want. You want it on a letterhead?
Yeah, I think it should be on the letterhead of this committee.
Okay, I can do that, and then it'll go to Wendy. And then there's no other substantive changes?
Does anybody have any substantive changes?
I think those will be for the next round. Whoever it happens to be, but the next round.
So for the changes that are non-controversial, which are recommended here, at what point should we, or the council, start making those changes?
As soon as possible. At least the these references can be done pretty quickly. The deletion of Chapter 290 subdivision regulations can be done quickly. And you know, I think that all of the fees will stay in place, even if we delete the ordinance under the statutes. The fees that were charged stay in place until such time as the departments pass their own fee schedules. I have a feeling, and Lynn, correct me if I'm wrong about this, that most departments have already done their own fee schedules since the 2011.
They probably do have them, yeah.
Right. So whatever departments have not yet gone to the departmental fee system, we'll have to do that. So this could be done early in the term, and you know, then you can probably send out to all the department heads, let them know this is happening, that they need to adopt their fee schedules. But I think that all of these we can start in January to the council. And then you guys can all say that you've got so much accomplished. You know, 35 ordinance amendments.
Oh,
and
gosh.
A bunch of fees.
You're
done for the rest of the term. You can rest on your laurels.
Well, it's a pretty simple ordinance, okay? I mean, delete, that's it. Delete chapter, what is it, what is it, 174 in its entirety?
And 290.
And 290 in its entirety. There you go. I don't think you have to repeat the whole ordinance. I mean, I think that would be kind of unnecessary.
Can you just tell me which one is table C?
Well, table C, I think, is going to be a combination of tables 3 and 4.
Okay.
Why don't I put them together for you and send them to you?
You don't trust me? We have trust issues already. We've just begun here.
Why don't you make those changes and send them to me?
There you go. Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else?
So do you want me to take my table and I'll put it in your format and then remove your...
Fine, whatever. I trust you.
I think your format is easier to understand as far as the where to make the changes.
Okay, I didn't say the title of each ordinance. Section just because, okay. Space saving. Okay.
How do we do with minutes for today? If we're going out of business.
Good question.
Can we just write minutes and vote on in this meeting? And that,
yeah.
The actual vote.
It's not like, you know, those council meetings where we can approve the council, just
right.
You and I will be. Non-quorum will be the only ones who vote on this.
So when is the, so we're going to be out of business after today.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it doesn't say explicitly that we dissolve, but I think that's understood that we deliver our report by the end of the year. And
I don't think there's any approval of minutes, ever.
But then you'd have to have minutes about that meeting.
Yeah, right.
When you're calling minutes at page 22, it's like...
What's on the administrative side for approval of minutes? Because, I mean, you guys fix that with your, you know, but this isn't a council committee, right?
Right.
It's just...
Yeah, right. I mean, I guess not. It's a special committee.
So what's the requirement for...
The last one I can think of was the redevelopment authority. They go out of business for a bit, and then they come back after a few years if needed. But they just stayed in a folder draft for next meeting, for approval at next meeting. That's what they did the last time. I don't know if that's right, but they hadn't met in years, and one member had already passed away.
And then a couple of years later, they went in and reviewed the minutes?
Well, it wouldn't be 5 years that the committee could do it in 5 years.
Pretty much the only decision we made was kind of a unanimous decision to approve the report with some changes. So can we somehow incorporate those into...
Do you want me to go write some minutes?
Yeah, we approve our minutes, like, this meeting now, or maybe we shouldn't even worry about it. Maybe it's not a major issue.
That's probably... That's right. I wonder, I mean, for any, you know, committee that's ad hoc or has legit, so there's probably that problem every time.
Every time?
Yeah.
And as Paul said, if we're gonna meet again to approve minutes, then we're gonna have to meet again to approve the minutes of that meeting. It's gonna end somewhere, so I'm happy with it ending here with the report.
Yeah, sure. Is there anything else? I mean, I don't know, Dad. Okay, motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Dissolve?
Dissolve, so moved.
All is fair.
Aye.